Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel, and today it's all about how to create a Final Cut library. Here we go. Let's throw 3 minutes on the clock. Let's get this done. Let's get straight to the point. Create new libraries. Here we go. First, we'll go ahead and open up Final Cut Pro. Then as this opens up, you have to decide, where is this library going to go? Do you want to save it locally to your hard drive or maybe an external hard drive? I'm going to choose File up in the top menu bar, go to New, choose Library, and it's going to ask me what do I want to call it and where do I want to put it. For this, I'll just say All Media. I can save it to my movies if I wanted, but I'm going to save it to my external hard drive and choose Save. So now on the top left, I have this brand new library that I can ingest media into. It creates a brand new event, which I can also name it later. If I select this library and go to the inspector in the top right, I can toggle on different settings for this library. For example, storage locations. If I choose modify settings, I can change where the media, where the motion content, the cache, and the backups all live. Naturally, I like to keep it all in the same spot. So you can say in library, and then choose backups. I usually put it on the external hard drive that the library lives on also. So those are my recommended settings. You can change it to whatever you'd like. I'll choose OK. So now notice here in the inspector, it shows exactly where all of this media lives. If I choose modify here, this allows me to change the color settings, the profile settings for the entire library itself. And your two options are standard or wide gamut HDR. If you're not familiar with that, you can do a search in the Final Cut help menu. Open up the table of contents here, scroll all the way down till you find color correction. And underneath color correction, do a little intro to color if you wanna learn a little bit more. But if you scroll down farther, you'll find wide color gamut and you can read the difference between all of those settings here on a more specific level. I'm gonna leave mine at standard, and so I'll choose cancel there, and that is creating a new library. Now if I go and let's say I wanna move that library to someplace else, if I don't wanna move it from here within the interface, if Final Cut Pro is quit, or if I quit out of Final Cut Pro, I can go to Finder, go back to where that media or that library was stored, and here it is down at the bottom. If I wanna move this entire library to another location, here's another way where I can just drag it and copy it to a different hard drive or locally on this computer. So that's a very quick way to create a brand new Final Cut library. I hope you enjoyed this very quick tutorial. If you have other questions, feel free to leave comments down below. And if you liked what you saw, and if you liked the other videos, show some love and hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next time.